everyone. Firstly, I hope all of you are at home safe and healthy. I'm working from home too. It is extremely, or rather it was extremely unimaginable that one could work seamlessly from home, especially when you have the market volatilities. But needless to say, thanks to the digital world, we're all seamlessly connected. So it is from home that I am talking about the month gone by, March 2020. But before that, I think a peek sneak into what happened in financial year 2020 from a bond market standpoint. We saw across categories do exceedingly well, whether it is a liquid category at the shortest end to the long duration funds, including the gilt and the bond. However, the month of March will go down so far as one of the most volatile periods in the bond markets. For starters, it wasn't only the month end, but also the quarter end and the year end. We also had a catalyst in the form of COVID-19, which created huge palpitations in the bond markets. We saw yields inch up to 3%, such that short end CDs, high grade CDs, were dealt way up to 8%, and high grade corporate bonds in the range of 2 to 4 years were dealt in the band of 8.5 to 8.75. Such was the panic in the market that we actually saw investors rushing to make an exit out of even liquid funds and park themselves into overnight funds. However, towards the end of the month, we saw the Reserve Bank of India advance their Monetary Policy Committee meeting, which was originally scheduled for April 3rd. And the good news is that we saw steep rate cuts and a slew of measures to actually cool off the otherwise ailing bond markets. We saw a rate cut of 75 basis points, which was pretty much the need of the hour, especially given that world central bankers have been acting in a coordinated manner, A, to ease the liquidity situation, and B, effect steep rate cuts to combat the coronavirus. It is true that medical emergency cannot be met by financial solutions, but the bond markets clearly needed some dose of ointment, and we are glad that the central banker has acted in this manner. Among the key measures, apart from the repo rate cut and CRR cut, I think what is most important for the bond markets is the LTRO, or the long-term repo operations, specifically ones which are targeted for buying corporate bonds. Under this facility, the banks in India can avail of up to 3-year loan or 3-year repo from the Reserve Bank of India, which in turn can be used to buy corporate bonds of investment grade and above. Now, this announcement, according to us, is one of the biggest brahmastra that the Reserve Bank of India has unleashed to ensure that there is order in the corporate bond market, which left to itself had seen yields rise to very unprecedented levels. We therefore believe that this, with the combination of the rate cuts, will bring about the desired anchoring of the bond yields in the weeks and the months coming ahead. The banking system continues to be comfortable on the liquidity front, and we believe that this liquidity situation is not likely to abate anytime soon. The government also saw the announcement of the first half of the financial year borrowing calendar on the government bond front. While there weren't too many surprises, about 60% of the total borrowing will be borrowed in the first 6 months. I think markets would be concerned about the demand levers to support this kind of a supply in the coming weeks and months ahead. Foreign investors, which is foreign portfolio investors, have been net sellers to the tune of almost 60,000 crores in the calendar year YTD, the 3 months gone by. With mutual funds not really getting long-term monies, it will be very interesting to see how this entire borrowing calendar actually goes through in an effortless manner. We believe that a combination of open market bond purchases and maybe private placements as and when necessary would give the necessary support or the boost to anchor bond yields on the government side. Currently, the bond yields on the 10-year benchmark is at about 6.25 to 6.3, maybe some small upticks during auction, but a broad range given the response to an open market bond purchase, as and when that happens, we could see the yield sliding towards the 6% range. So a broad range of 6 to 6.35 kind of range would be the near to medium term range for the bond on the gilt side to trade. Therefore, on a risk reward basis, we believe that incremental allocations on the fixed income side could do with a combination of ultra short, short and mid duration funds. We believe that the spreads in the corporate bonds, especially the high grades, are reasonably lucrative for investors to consider allocations in these kinds of market. We have seen unprecedented events across us, and therefore central bankers across the world have been taking out-of-box measures, including our own central bank. Depending on how the COVID situation pans out, we could expect many more such measures, including rationalizing interest rates, if there were to be a need. But for now, the current sharp rate cuts are sufficient enough, combined with liquidity, to keep the bond markets buoyant for now. On a last note, I request each one of you to really not give in to whispers, murmurs and rumors, which obviously are doing rounds at a time when things are in confusion. It is prudent enough for you to reach out to your asset manager, to reach out to your advisor, and when in doubt, always confirm facts before acting on anything. The same would hold good for exiting a particular category or a particular investment completely, because that would mean giving in or succumbing into the current pressure surroundings, which definitely is not the need of the hour. The way we need to keep ourselves healthy, we believe that we need to keep our financial investments also in best shape. On that note, stay safe, stay healthy, and happy investing. Thank you.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.